This is Danny reporting to you from my childhood home. I'm gonna get this out of the way right now. This video, it's probably gonna suck if you like my regular videos. There's gonna be no Inland Iggy, no Leo. This was gonna be a week off. There was gonna be no video, but I thought some of you might prefer some sort of content, any kind of content. It's gonna be a tour of my childhood home with me telling you many embarrassing stories and giving you the fucking dirt on why I grew up to be such a sick bastard. And the reason I'm doing this, guys, is because pretty much I'm burnt out. I mean, this 6 months, it feels like it's been a fucking year. I mean, we've put out so many great goddamn videos. If I had to say my least favorite video of these 6 months, I'd say maybe the Chinatown one was a little rushed. But I mean, basically it's just been good video after good video. I've been working 70, 80 hour weeks to get the content out. And it's gotten to the point where I feel like I'm starting to burn out and I'm not gonna have enough steam to make it until December. So I'm taking 2 weeks. One, I'm just gonna spend getting hammered and trying to get laid. The other, I'm gonna spend just writing and studying comedy so that I have some material to take me through a few months when I do get back into the swing of putting out regular videos. So I'm just leaving you with this. Kind of something that most big YouTubers put out. It takes them like 3 hours to make instead of the 60, 70, 80 hours it takes me to make a fucking video. So yeah, this is Danny Mullen's try at being a regular YouTuber who doesn't put in any effort and who fucking sucks. That's what this is right here. So let's go in now into my childhood home in Orangevale, California. My parents still live here, by the way. It's not like the owners are away on vacation and I'm breaking and entering. I lock the door behind me whenever I'm in a house because I assume if I don't do that, people will come in and do bad stuff to me. In my home in LA, I have a gun by my bed, so it's not so frightening, but here, I don't know where the gun is. So this is my parents' room. I glimpsed my mom naked once in here, kind of on purpose. I sensed that she was gonna take a shower. This was, I don't know if I was 3 or 4, but I remember hiding under the covers and peeking out and pretending I was taking a nap to see what a naked woman's body looked like. And for years, I was traumatized by that. I thought I was basically a serial killer, and I was trying to keep my secret from society. But I think in Freud, they call it the primal scene or something. Or the primal scene is when you watch your parents fucked. I never got that adventurous. But I did wait for my mom to come out of the shower and I scoped out the titty. So I did that in this bed. It was probably a different bed. I mean, we're talking almost 3 decades ago, but here we go. My childhood bedroom. Look at this fucking place. This was the room I first jerked off in. It used to be a bunk bed right here. And I remember, I swear to God, the first time I jerked off, I had an interesting progression. None of the fist stuff, that came really late. My first time jerking off, I just humped the shit out of the pillow. And I remember the orgasm sustained itself for probably a full 4 minutes. It was incredible. I don't know what it was. I couldn't achieve orgasm after a while humping pillows, so my strategy changed to this. I would rub a fucking my cock on the inside of my wrist like this until I orgasmed. And I started jerking off so early, these were all dry orgasms. But for a while, because all of my jerk-off techniques were built around just humping stuff, not like pumping in and out of a hole, but just rubbing the cock on things. When I first learned about what sex was and the existence of the vagina, I thought you just rubbed your cock on a girl's belly until it felt really good, and then you rammed it up the cunt real quick, and that got her pregnant. I didn't understand that humping consisted of putting it in the hole and going in and out. So my next thing that I did jerking off, because I used to hang out with this kid named Aaron. I'm not gonna say his last name, I almost did. He would come over and he was such a fiend that he would just jerk off all the time while I was in the room with him. I used to jerk off when we were playing video games, and his technique was like this. He would go whole life, so this was right here in this room, once again. I'd be playing N64 or something right there. This motherfucker would be back on the bed, sprawled out here, and he'd go the ring technique, 3 fingers out ring, and he would stroke like that. And that was my new thing going forward. None of the sloppy penis on the forearm shit. I was done. I'd outgrown that. The problem came when I told all my buddies at school that that's how I jerked off, and they started giving me shit for having a small dick, which I guess it makes sense because this doesn't cover a lot of vertical surface area. So eventually, I went full-blown fist. This is all in the process of about 1.5 years, and I haven't looked back since. This room is big for beating off. This is like the room where the Declaration of Independence was signed, wherever that room is. But the first jerk off ever was up on this, when the bed was here, when I humped the fuck out of my pillow, when I raped my pillow. I'll just come out and say it. It wasn't consensual. Next big moment, I produced my first dollop of semen. I was watching a Vin Diesel movie. I can't recall which one. Don't think it was Triple X, but there was no shortage of Vin Diesel movies in the early 2000s. And on the screen came a light-skinned stripper, half black or something like that, with fake titties. With all the speed of a hummingbird, I got on that pause button, pulled out my pecker, and rubbed it. And this was maybe right before I went into freshman year or sophomore year. I was a really late puberty bloomer. And it was just a little dollop, just a little fucking, just a little dropper full of semen that that peeked out of my cock when I jerked off to Vin Diesel's stripper broad in this film, but that's all I needed. So this is my sister's room. And when she went away to college, I beelined it for this motherfucker. I moved in. The only thing I could think of that was interesting in this room that I did is I used to jerk off into condoms. Because the first time I tried a condom on, it was like a midget getting wrapped in a deflated circus tent. It just didn't even fit my dick a little bit. And I remember that was a blow to my ego, even though I had to have known on some level my cock would get bigger once I passed the age of 7. The day I tried a condom on and beat off into it and it fit and everything worked out and I felt like I could go have sex with a girl and it would be safe, that was another big day. That day was in second place to the day I produced that dollop of cum to Vin Diesel. For a few weeks in a row, I was obsessed with the idea of flexing my new power and masturbating into condoms. And the problem was, you don't want your parents to find a wrinkled up Trojan full of semen. So what do you do with the wrinkled up Trojan full of semen? You flush it down the fucking toilet. So I started just flushing, like, I'm talking 3 condoms a day. And I thought I was in the clear. But then, let me take you to the little spot where Danny Mullen paid the fiddler. I smashed a plate out here last night. The I fired him video was slow to upload and it didn't end up coming out until Friday morning. I was so fucking mad, I wanted to smash my phone or my computer. Of all the options, I'm pretty glad I went with the plate. Back to the jerking off and condom stories. When you move these stones right here, these lead to a fucking sewer. And one day, I swear to God, my dad called me over. And whenever my dad talks to me, basically, he only comes to me with bad news these days. Back then, it was the same. Called me over in that somber dad voice. Like, he called me over as if he'd found the raped and beaten corpse of one of my high school classmates up in the fucking brush up here somewhere. I came over and he said, I found something in the sewer. I found multiple somethings in the sewer. I've been finding prophylactics. These can't go in the sewer, Danny. These can't go down the toilet. You need to throw these in the wastebasket. And I think I tried to deny it. I didn't take credit for it. I mean, maybe, just maybe there was some thought in his head that my sister was coming home from college and getting drilled out back there and just flushing everything and it wasn't the sun. I know he didn't think I was getting laid back then. There wasn't a shot. I'm gonna go out and take a piss on the lawn. The beauty of living out here on 3 acres growing up, you just come outside and you can fucking take a piss wherever you want. You just take a fucking piss, dude. It doesn't matter. Nobody can see you. Nobody cares. Nobody's gonna call the cops. You're not gonna be a registered sex offender. I probably am gonna be anyway, but it's not gonna be from peeing in my parents' backyard. So this is stuff. I don't know. I've completely got off the rails. Now it's just like this is a fucking field. In case you wanted to see the field behind my parents' house. We used to shoot bow and arrows at turkeys. I once threw a bottle of wild turkey at a wild turkey. One of my proudest accomplishments. Down here, we had this dog that was a fucking stupid Gordon setter. They just like follow scents all over the place. And she ran out onto a busy street, got hit by a fucking car. We had to bury her ass right there. It was a Gordon setter. Well, not right there, there's a Gordon setter. You can't see it or anything. She's like 5-6 feet underground and probably not even bones anymore. Just like decomposed chemicals and stuff. I don't know, I'm not a scientist. What do you turn into, carbon and shit? That was a very cold-hearted description of her death. I'm sorry about that. Sarah, good dog, Sarah. Well, if we got some more dead animals over here, I'll take you to the pet cemetery. Here there's a dead Labrador and a dead Dachshund and maybe a dead cat or two also. The dead Labrador's name was Peach and she was my childhood family dog. One time I just laid on top of her like a missionary and it's like I wanted to experiment with what that would feel like to lay on top of in a sexual fashion. Like a warm body, and I just laid on top of the fucking dog. And like penetrate her or anything. She was a chick, so I guess I could have. But yeah, that's my one really embarrassing story with that dog. And then I... See, I thought this would be a huge admission if I told you people this. But the thing is, Louis C.K. already admitted to something similar on the radio once, but I definitely got the dachshund to do the fucking peanut butter trick. Like, I 100% smeared some fucking peanut butter on the tip of my dick once. I can't even recall how. I was like in fourth grade or something, and I absolutely compelled the dachshund to come over and lick a little bit off. But like, the thing is, it sucks. Like, I don't think anybody in the world, I take that back immediately. I know somebody in the world has gotten off and gone to climax from that. But the thing with a dog is, like, your dog doesn't turn into Jenna Jameson or doesn't turn into like Layla Starr the second you smear a little jiff on the tip. It just, they fucking come and they lick disinterestedly until the peanut butter's gone. Or not even, because they can sense there's something wrong. They're like, I can sense from the guilt radiating off my owner's being right now that I'm doing something and he's doing something that we are not supposed to be doing. So like, she didn't even finish the tiny helping of Jif. She took one disinterested lick and walked away. We buried her in there. I had her from like third grade until, I don't know, when I was like out of college writing books. I was a long-lived dachshund, like 16 years. What else goes on around here? The first time I got drunk, I fell out of that fucking horse barn right there. And that's a big drop too. That's maybe even more than 15 feet. There used to be an above ground pool here, like a poor person's pool. We had one of those, a big blue thing. And I fell out of this fucking barn, just drunk as shit. Tried to jump into the pool, but there was a gap right here you had to clear. And I just misstepped and I fell right on the fucking edge of the pool. And by some miracle of God, I didn't hit my spine or my head. I just hit the back of my thigh and then tumbled back first onto the ground. It was probably the most fortuitous thing that could have happened given how shittily I took off out of the door. That was the summer before going into my freshman year of high school. My sister was having a party. People say that the first time they get high, they don't really feel like they're high. First time I got drunk, I didn't know I was drunk. It was the same kind of thing. You have nothing to compare it to. I must have had 8 drinks in my system, and back then I weighed 125 pounds. So shit-faced, absolutely shit-faced. Yeah, there's just pictures of me smoking Swisher sweets and trying to fuck my sister's friends. If you're paying attention to the timeline, that was before I was capable of producing semen, so I certainly couldn't have impregnated any of them. But that didn't stop me from diving out of that barn. And that reminds me, the reason I dove out of the barn to try to get into the pool is because all my sister and her friends were all topless fucking swimming around the pool, and I wanted to be in a better proximity to them. That actually reminds me, I'm gonna save the best for last here. I got something real fucking juicy. This is my parents' room. My parents were working because it was summertime, but me and my sister and one of my sister's friends were home. But for a while, her and this girl took to skinny dipping all the time, and they were skinny dipping out back in our fucking pool. They were out here, and this is where I just showed you where I fell. There used to be the big blue pool out there. I was sitting here. You can see there's a nice little seat, this sink. I was sitting on this sink, cock as hard as volcanic rock, trying to focus on the girl who was not related to me by blood. But you know, in my peripherals, my sister's tits were bouncing around. And so I was like technically jerking off to my sister. But I came everywhere. When you jerk off the two topless girls in a pool when you're 14, you're creating a pool of your own. Down at your feet. In this case, right down here somewhere. So yeah, that's what happened there.